Hello students. So basically it is lecture number one. I am starting the second chapter, that is Principles of Management of BSc. Principles of Management. So this is chapter number two, lecture number one. So what I will do, I will just make a slot of 15 minutes each for each lecture, 14 to 15 minutes each for each lectures, and I will give in this way that first chapter you have completed, so it contained the total number of lectures equals to 15. So here second chapter I have started, so I am naming it as lecture number one. Now what are the principles of management? What is called principle? Do you know? Principle, in one word you can say that it's certain rules or regulations that are need to be followed. You can say it is certain sort of guideline. Guidelines. Just take one example that after completing plus 2, that is plus 12 examination, board examination, you will decide that which line you want to go for. That is whether you want to go for CS, CMS, CS or MBA Finance or some other. So this guideline, you have to take this guideline from someone, from somebody. Maybe some teacher or maybe from a professional itself. So now each and everything in our life, to take a decision, we need some guidelines to follow. Here also in management, as you have seen, that it is completely professional in nature, formal in nature. So without the proper management, it is impossible to run a company. It is impossible to survive also if management is not there. Now here also for management, there should be some principles, some rules, some guidelines. There should be like these things to be followed, 1, 2, 3, 4. Managers can do this and manager will not do this. So there may be some which work to be done, that is right mark and correct mark, and which is not to be done, that should be crossed. So these kinds of principles, so that management can move on more efficiently and effectively, it is very much important. Because you are only producing a particular final product, producing a particular good, maybe it mobile or any electronics, maybe it furniture, maybe anything. But ultimately, if management is not good, you will see that if the cost of the phone that you have produced would have been 2500 rupees, if proper management is not there, the same phone will cost 7 to 8,000 for you. So from where you will make the profit? Because competitors are sitting all over. If you are not following proper management, it is impossible to earn profit. And as you have seen in the first chapter, if you are not earning profit, then you cannot survive in this industry. Right. Now we will see detail about principles of management. So what you can say here, you can write with me as well, though I will just give you a snapshot, but then also if you want you can write the key points. What is a managerial principle? So here we will say it as managerial principle. Managerial principle, not PAL, it's PLE. Okay, so what to write here? It is a broad and general guideline. Broad guideline, it should be a broad guideline. Plus, what we can say? General guideline. For what this guideline will be provided? For decision making purpose. Isn't it? For decision making purpose. That what are the things to be done in which situation and what are the things that should be ignored in that situation, right? And behavior. What kind of behavior a manager needs to maintain? It is not so that a manager will always maintain a friendly behavior with his workers. If it is so, then the workers will think him just as a friend and they will not work seriously. So a minimum professional gap should be there between the manager and the workers. So it is also very much important to know that what kind of behavior will be pursued by the manager so that the work can be done through others. That is meant by management, so that the work can be done through others. So getting the work done through others, this is the main concept. Now you see, management principle, how does it helps? Management principles help managers to perform their functions effectively and efficiently. That the thing I am telling you from the very beginning. So ultimately objective is what? Ultimate objective is to perform the functions effectively and efficiently, isn't it? Fine. Thus, it is very much important that we should understand that what does principles of management mean. Fine. So let's see. Principles of management. So what are those? First one, management principles are not rigid. Not rigid means in the pure science, what happens? Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Newton's third law of motion. When you were younger, you have already studied this. So, what does it mean that you cannot change this theory? When an apple will fall from the tree, it will not go upwards, but it will fall downwards. What does it mean? Yes, it is a true, it is a theory which can't be changed. That principle, that particular theory cannot be changed. So here the management principles are not rigid that much as principles of pure science. Clear? Yes, some principles are there. They can be changed and updated continuously so that the business environment, whatever the changing demands will be there. When the customer, suppose I have a clothes store, okay, retail clothes store. There I have raincoats, I have sweaters, I have cotton suits and each and everything. Now, during winter season, cotton suits, I cannot sell much of the cotton suits. Why? That time the demand for sweaters will be high. But at the time of summer, like this time, April, May, June. So that time, the sweaters will not be of use, of any kind of use. So rather it is better to keep aside. Now then the role of cotton suits come into play. What people will do, customer will search for the cotton suits, cotton shirts, all these things for the temperature of the weather. So it is a changing environment. The season is changing. So according to the season, the fluctuations of demand will be there for different kinds of dresses. So according to that, we have to produce those things which are in demand at the present situation and at the present circumstances. At rainy season, we will design raincoats. At winter, we will design sweaters. And at summer, we will design curtains. So this is the thing. According to the changing demands, we can change the principle accordingly. I think it is clear. Number two is that management principles are related to human behavior. Thus, they need to be used creatively. Related to human behavior. What does it mean, students? Can you say? When you are dealing with the management, you are dealing with the people. So when you are dealing with the people, can you measure that how much of the quantity is Mr. A honest? How much of the quantity he is responsible? You cannot measure because it's a behavior. You can say human beings are an asset of the organization, but they are intangible ones, but they are valuable. So when management, for management, we have to deal with the human behavior. So we have to use creativity. It's not that apple that whenever it will fall into the ground only. So it's the people's mind which should be played with tactfully so that the work can be done. Right? Number three. Management principles cannot be tested in any laboratory. Okay. So it cannot be tested. How it can be tested, students? How it is possible that the management principles can be tested? Because these are working with the human. So we have already studied in point number two, it is related to the human behavior. So it cannot be tested in the laboratory. Now, number four, application of same principle in different situations may have different results, unlike pure science principles which give same results all the time. So different situation, will lead to different result, isn't it? Like this example, whenever the circumstances will change, our strategy needs to be changed, but it is the principle, the same method, same policy should be used, that the behavior should be same, the incentives that is to be provided to the workers will be same, everything will be same, but the main aim will be different. Main aim, that is output, what is to be produced, how to produce, each and everything will be different one. But one guideline will be there that you cannot use this, you cannot do this and that, you have to follow this method like this. So in different situation, one principle can have different results. So now, student, this is lecture number one. In lecture number two, I will be providing with you about principles of management are different from techniques of management. Principles of management are different from values, nature of principles of management and all that. So just complete this lecture number one and all the best. Just follow lecture number two now.